Let's look at the interface of Microsoft Word 2016. On the top, you have what's called ribbon menu, and in this ribbon menu, you have multiple categories. I'm in the Home tab right now. There are also File tab, Insert, Design, and you can just, by clicking on the tab, you can quickly switch in between. Each ribbon tab has its own category. So Clipboard, Font, Paragraph, Styles, and Editing. These are the typical sections in the Home ribbon tab. We also, in the upper right corner, in the lower right corner, we have a zooming interface, so we can zoom in and zoom out real quick. And you can also, by clicking on the button, do it. We can switch to a different layouts, print layout, web layout, and also in the read mode to see which one works the best for you. And here in the lower left corner, we see how many pages we have, how many words, and some other statistical information that's helpful. As you're probably well aware, Microsoft Word document is designed managing the text. So I have a sentence here. This is my first Word document. And what you see a dots instead of spaces here. And the way I turn it on or off is by clicking this button in the paragraph section. I like this, but some people see it as confusing. It also allows me to see the end of the line breaks. But let's first start with looking at the clipboard section and see what we can do here. If we select this text, then I'm using the mouse to do the selection, and then I can work with the selected text. And this is what this clipboard section is all about. We can copy this text, put the cursor to the next line and click paste button, and it copied and pasted the text. We can also cut the text. So if I select the second line and I click cut, it put it into clipboard, but it also cut it. I can paste it back. And I can paste it many times, it will take the text from the clipboard and it will put it into the Microsoft Word document. Let's look at what we can do with text. If we select the text that we typed, we can change the font properties. And you can do it two ways. You can select it and use the font section here, or you can do a right mouse click. And you see on top, it shows pretty much the same options. We can make it bold, we can make it italic or bold and italic as I did, and we can also make it underline. So combination of these three properties allows you to choose. You can pick the font color, or we can pick the highlight color right behind this text. And we can pick the styles, and styles is a separate conversation. It's a bigger topic because it allows you to do a lot of different things. As you can see, the style we select right now is just called normal style. Now let's look at the paragraph section of the Home ribbon tab. In paragraph section, what we can do, we can do different things related to paragraph. We can do bullets, we can do numbers, or we can increase indentation or decrease indentation. For example, if we're looking at this to-do list, what we can do, we can make the title of the list as bold, and you see that I misspelled the grocery here, so it highlighted it with the red line, and I just did right mouse click and picked the correct word. But now we're focusing on the paragraph section, so in paragraph you can make it as bullets. That's one way to do it, and I'm gonna disable the paragraph mark so you can see as it's a real word document. We can also make it as numbers, or we can do it as hierarchical number, what's called in Word multi-level list. Let's look at the styles section in Microsoft Word. So for example, if you are writing a book, you might have three chapters in the book, chapter one, chapter two, and chapter three here. And I'm going to delete using the delete button. So we see chapter three here as well. And styles are designed to help us organize data that you might need to present. And there are multiple benefits for you using the styles. For example, chapter one might be heading one style. Regular text is typically a normal style, and that's what we see. Chapter two also might be heading one style. But now see chapter two, instead of just text, it has subsection 2.1, and subsection would be the next heading style, which would be heading two. And then we have also subsection 1, and this would be the text inside of subsection 2.1. Then we will have subsection, this is extra text, subsection 2.2. We will just use heading 2 style, and chapter 3 would be heading 1 style. One big benefit of using this type of structures, it allows you to use internal features for Microsoft Word to do navigation. So if we go to View and then select Navigation Pane, you see on the left, now it builds the hierarchical structure. And chapters are on one level, but subsections would be on a different level. Let's take a look at how can we do basic operations in Microsoft Word. How we can add text, delete text, move text in your documents. The text which you see currently on the screen is the simple text that I put as, in this tutorial. It contains multiple sentences, and what we can do, we can select the text by using the mouse, right, and using the left mouse click. A couple ways you can copy the text. We can copy it using the copy button. And if we put the cursor somewhere else, we can paste the same text that we just copied. Right. We can also undo this operation. There is an undo paste button. Or if this is not something that we really wanted, meaning undoing it, we can also redo the typing. We can also see more details about the text. If we click this Show Hide button, it shows some additional characters that typically do not show up. For example, this dot in the middle of the line indicates a space. This symbol indicates end of the line. And page break indicates that after this line, text will go right into the next page. The copy and paste operation is also available through the menu. So if I highlight this large paragraph here, I can do a right mouse click, and there's a copy option available here. So I can do copy. I can add an extra line here by clicking enter button, and I can do a paste through the menu as well. So and there are different paste options. This is just keep source formatting, and that's the type of paste that I chose. We can also move text without copying and pasting. To do that, we just need to select the text that we would like to move, and using the left mouse button holding this, we can just drag it and drop it in the new place. And obviously, we can undo this operation using the undo button on pressing Ctrl Z on the keyboard. Deleting text is done, deleting of the text is done in multiple different ways. We can highlight the text and we can do cut. It removes it from the text, but it remembers it in the clipboard in case we need it. Or we can select the text and use the delete button on the keyboard. It permanently deletes the text without putting it into the clipboard, but you can still undo this operation using the undo button. In this section, we're going to look at the basics of organizing the document, Microsoft Word document. Typical need is to break document into multiple sections. So, for example, what you're looking at on the screen right now is the document that contains three sections. And this is pretty simplistic. All of the chapter information for chapter 1, chapter 2, or chapter 3 is all on the same page. But reality is the chapter 1 might have 5, 10 pages or even more. Chapter 2 might be same large content, and same for chapter 3. And there might be 10 chapters or 20 chapters. So what Word provides is the very good way of organizing and navigating through this organization that you're putting together by using the styles. So all styles are highlighted here in this section in the ribbon. You see the style section. In the key styles, you can expand this section to see more styles. You can just go back and forth, or you click expand. And the regular text is typically a normal style, but we also have heading one style, heading two, heading three. And this is typically to build a hierarchy of styles. And I'll explain it to you in a second and demonstrate how you do it. So what I'm going to do right now, I am going to assign style heading one to chapter one. I'm going to move the cursor to chapter two and name of the section and put and say this is also heading one, and chapter three would also be heading one. And what it allows me to do, obviously, it's a nice way to automatically highlight this section. And what I'm using some special characters, hide and show feature of the word, so it's easy to navigate. But I just disabled it so it's easier to see. It looks more like a regular Word document. But now what we can do, we can show you how it's helpful with navigation. So I'm going to click the View tab here, and I'm going to select the Navigation pane. And you see that these three chapters that I have here in the document, we can navigate between them. I also have additional chapters and subsections in the same document, and it highlights this in the table of content area or navigation pane document. So you can also build, as I mentioned, a table of content from this information, so it will automatically look at everything that has a heading style and include it into the table of content. And when you have heading one, it shows all this information in this level. But subsections would be heading two, and you can also have a subsections or subchapters, and that would be heading three. So having those things in place allows you to build a hierarchical structure, which is very easy to manage and assign, and also very easy to navigate. Let's take a look how you can find and replace the text. That's one of the coolest feature of every editor, text editor. It allows you to do massive finds in the large volumes of text and also massive replacements. So for example, how do I identify all words that say tutorial in this document? I highlight the word, that's the easiest way I'm showing you, and then there is a, in the upper right corner, there is a find button, or you can do Control F. So I click it, and you see it shows me tutorial, and it also finds and shows all the places in the document, and I can move between them by clicking it on the left that has this word. And as you can see, there are quite a few of those places. Now, a lot of times what you also need to do, in addition just to find the word, you can just type it manually and replace it maybe with text. Right, that's my replacement. But let's say I want to do replacement on the massive scale. So for that, there is a replace function in the same area right under the find button. We click on the replace. For example, word tutorial we want to replace with word manual. Right? And I can do replacements one by one just by clicking replace button. So it finds the word tutorial. You see it highlighted on the screen. I click replace, and it replaced it right here with the word manual. Or I can, if I know for sure that yes, this is what I want to do, I can just click replace all. And it did 34 replacements in this document. One of the features of Microsoft Word is ability to work with tables. In order to add tables to the document, you need to click on the Insert tab, and there is a Table button. And here it allows you to highlight and select the dimensions of the table. So if I select a 3x2 table, it's going to insert it, and it would allow me to start typing. So for example, this would be item, description, and price. And those are the things I can add into a table. And for example, item might be echo, device, description might be Amazon Echo, and price might be $49.99, and I'll use the dollar sign. If I click tab button, it will add another row to the table, and I can also apply copy and paste operations to the table. I just need to highlight the row I'm trying to, let's say, replicate. I go back to home and click copy, select the new row and click paste. It allows me to do that. I can also cut, obviously use any of the clipboard operations for that. I can also highlight the header here and make it bold, the text here. I can change the alignment maybe by making it a center. I can also change the background color by selecting the background color and choosing a different background color. So this way allows me to highlight the header. It looks like the left alignment is a little bit better, so that's what I'm going to keep. Microsoft Word allows saving into PDF as one of the options on the Save As menu. So if you're trying to save the document as PDF file, you just need to click File, Save As, and there is an option here on the list of Save File Type, Save As. And you pick the PDF file. And you pick the name of the PDF file that you want to save and click Save. And it brings that document in the Adobe Reader as a PDF file. So this is very simple, and this is all different aspects, most of the different aspects of the Word file retained. A couple cool things that might be useful for you when you consider a PDF file. If you're doing the link, let's say we want to link this to external website and keep this link in PDF file, we do insert link, and let's say link might be www.microsoft.com. We create this link. So now it's linkable. We need to do control click to follow this link in the Word document, but when we save it as PDF file, save as PDF, and we'll just do a version 2. I'll rename the file. But you see it becomes link in PDF file as well. When we're deciding how to print Microsoft document, we have a lot of options to consider. Just the regular printing, if you need to just do a printing, you print as is, and Microsoft Word provide a lot of default functions. So you just do File, Print, and the document shows up in Print Preview. You can zoom in, zoom out here and see and scroll through all the pages for the document to see. If you'd like to change something though, you need to go to Layout option, and there are a lot of things available. You can change margins. This is the areas that surround the text on the page. You can make them normal. Right now they're normal. You can make them narrow, moderate, wide, based on what you need. You can change orientation of the page from portrait, which is right now, to landscape. And this is how landscape page looks. Then you can change the size of the page, pick different document. Insert line breaks, hibernation, create columns, and do a lot of different things. You can also click on the page setup here, and all of these options come up in one screen. Hope you have learned something and enjoyed this video. Make sure to click the subscribe button to stay in touch with me on YouTube. And join my email list so I can share with you more information about my free training courses. Hope to see you back soon. Again, this is Vadim Mikhailenko. Thanks again for watching.